Peace, peace, peace. Welcome back to another episode of 33 Hip Hop's Audio Visual Art. That's right, I'm your host, Jim from 33. And you know where we at. We live and direct in the King Heartbeat Studios with Coolie Chat, the bigger boss behind the boards. We appreciate all the love. We appreciate the support. And we appreciate everybody definitely tuning in, especially those of you that subscribe to the channel. And if you haven't, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and definitely hit the notification bell so you know when we're coming with the new audiovisual artwork each and every week. But we're not going to waste no time. Let's get right into this week's joint. Here we go. When we entered the 36 Chambers in 1993, Wu-Tang made history. Not because the album was a commercial success, not because it was met with critical acclaim, but because this was one of the first times in hip-hop where a group would be signed to a label deal that would allow each individual member to seek solo deals elsewhere with a record company of their choosing. Method Man went with Def Jam, ODB went with Elektra, and while others scattered about to various different labels to find their own success, Loud Records wouldn't let one artist go so easy. That would be Shalal Raekwon, better known to the masses as Raekwon the Chef. And their efforts to keep him at the home base paid off, as his debut album, Only Built for Cumalinks, would become an instant classic. And here's one of my favorite joints off the album. Here's Raekwon with Glaciers of Ice.
Check it out. Just imagine you bought navy
in 1995,
blue, right? Navy blue,
a lot of MCs was claiming King of New York. But when Raekwon dropped this, when he threw on them fatigues, he threw his hat in the ring and let cats know he wasn't playing. Bebop, Gun Cock, Avalanche Rock, Getting Fatal, Mass Murderous Services, Chef, break 'em, watch the alley cats bake 'em. Woo! At this particular point in time, I hadn't heard rhyme schemes like that. I hadn't heard beats like that. And I hadn't heard aggressiveness like this in a long time. But Raekwon brought it. Throw me like three bags of Seth. If you're seeing this for the first time, I apologize because you might not have the same feeling in your chest as I do. But this was an amazing time period. Pull off a Keystone caper. Proceed with caution as he enters the symphony. Degrees of punishment increase intensely. Signals was caused by the deadly drums, but the battle was won by swords being swung. Shout out to Master Killer, one of the most underrated MCs in hip-hop history, line for line, bar for bar. His ability to come on the track calm alongside any MC proves his how superior MC he is. But let's talk about that another time. Vital sparks from the artery. Shout out to Blue Raspberry on the background vocals, which was unique to a Wu-Tang track. You knew when you heard Blue Raspberry taking you there. Now listen to Ghostface. Piece of them check cashing, chain snatching, gun flashing, brothers in the hood, bubbling goods, analyze stocks. We'll be buying lion heads and cloths. Start to be home soon. Catch you 96 in June. 10-man team, be safe. You could all get laced. Sit daiquiris and max swimming pools. Black kids. But whatever, I gotta hit other sides of the earth. My crew keeps pretty boys paranoid. My seeds grow with his seeds, marry his seeds. That's how we keep Wu-Tang money all up in the family. I was supposed to be doing the analysis and I end up singing the whole joint. That's how this joint hit me in my chest. My wife told me I should stop buying Clarks. they outdated. I just copped a new pair, and I ain't gonna stop buying them, whether it's like blue or cream. That's how much I love the wool. One of the classic videos for one of the classic, most aggressive hip-hop tracks of all time. And Ray and Ghost, Master Killer, deserve their props in hip-hop history. And RZA for leading the ship. The saga continues, and we got more, a lot more Wu-Tang to bring on the show.
Shorty, you don't even have to go to summer school. All you gotta do is pick up the Wu-Tang double CD, and you get all the education you need this year. Now, in 1997, I genuinely believed the RZA. And while that might have been a stretch, I did learn quite a bit from the Wu in my younger years. I definitely learned that I should protect my neck at all times. I learned that when living in a materialistic society, cash does rule everything around me. And I definitely learned that I can't party my life away because my seeds would grow up the same way. But fast forward to 2021, I think that in my adult years, the biggest lesson I learned from the Klan is to never look down on the opportunity to work with others. Now, many people fail to realize that the Wu was really a group of solo artists that came together for a common cause. And as expected, the outcome was beneficial for them both personally and as a collective. But in today's society, when most people would scoff at the idea of working in a group if they can't be the front person, the Wu are a living manifestation of the saying that none of us is as smart as all of us. So before you dismiss the chance to work in a group with the thoughts that it will dull your solo shine, remember that thoughtful collaboration always divides the task and multiplies the success. Alright, y'all. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of 33 Hip Hop's Audio Visual Art. That's right, I'm your host, Jim from 33. And we appreciate each and every one of you tuning in to support the channel. We appreciate the likes, we appreciate the comments. We definitely want those of you that haven't subscribed yet to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you could keep up with all the new content that we got coming week to week. But we're not going to waste no time. Until next week, thank you for tuning in. Peace.